An excerpt from the conversation with Svaru of Era. Consciousness manifests DNA from higher planes with the principle of standing waves and dominant frequencies. But from the subatomic level, growing in complexity towards the atomic. The simple molecular structures, then the complex ones, which will form amino acids and other elements necessary to create a DNA molecule. This always follows a pattern in the manner of construction plans on a higher plane. These blueprints will always follow mathematical patterns of sacred geometry that are unique to each consciousness and individual, never the same, just as no two snowflakes will ever be the same. The best evidence of this is how the Fibonacci sequence prevails in nature. A snail, a leaf of a fern plant, the movement of a pendulum. The same mathematics is everywhere. And that of the toroid, also the same mathematics, but a step more complex. The toroid being the basis for everything material, from an atom to a cell, an apple, a planet or star, a galaxy. Originally in Spanish, second part of 2022.
Yassi, do you know anything about the human genome?
Something. It depends on what, or if what I know is compatible with what is being said.
I don't know if they've made any discoveries, perhaps. I don't know if they also question the human genome as such. I don't understand that much. I understand that the genome is tied to the DNA.
I am not aware whether or not they discovered anything recently. What I do know is that, as with everything, what they tell the public is way behind the level they are really at. They have only decided to tell this or that extra thing to the public as long as it serves one of their purposes or agendas. From my understanding, the genome is the set of DNA that makes up human genetics. If there are differences in definitions, I am not yet aware of it. I see no difference.
Can the genome of every human be stored, or is the human genome something general? In other words, is there a general human genome?
That could be the definition. Genome as of the race, DNA as of the individual, but I speculate. And yes, it can be stored as a set of genetic characteristics given by DNA that has been decided to represent or is present in all human beings as a common bulk.
Okay, as a race, and what would the repercussions of storing all the DNA of all the individuals on Earth be?
It depends on whether for good or for bad. If the DNA of all people were stored, when someone gets sick, this information can be used to correct the damage, whatever it is, by programming the data in a medical pod. This is mostly for damage caused by trauma, since metabolic damage is more difficult to correct with a medical pod, because it tends to be recurrent. And for the bad, you can use the data to obtain the specific frequency of each individual and thus use technologies such as synthetic telepathy to control that individual, what he thinks, what he will get sick of and when, all by remote control, and would go hand in hand with the agendas of injecting nanotechnological graphenes. It can also be used to force a soul consciousness signal into particular individual, as DNA is also a map of frequencies specific to each individual. This using immersion pods.
Wow. I see both sides, the good and the bad. That's Elon Musk's next proposition? To store the DNA of all humans alive on Earth?
Yes, and that's where you can see that Musk is not on the good side. Because that collection of everyone's DNA is already underway. Among other collection systems are PCR tests, blood tests from clinical labs, and police agency databanks, among the like. It's all going into a central databank that is under the control of the cabal, with people like Gates and Musk as public fronts. Remember, they are just fronts and lack the real power that people attribute to them. Another agenda regarding DNA databanks is to know who is who, to know where they come from, to detect non-human beings inside human biosuits. This as an attack on starseeds and stepdowns.
I remember that DNA can also be altered by mind control. So, DNA can vary according to your collective unconscious here on Earth?
That's right. It alters over time, as the individual ages, wherever they live. Human science only sees that the telomeres shorten, the tips of the chromosomes. But in reality, everything is altered with the passage of time by the evolution of the individual's consciousness as a result of the experiences that he, she accumulates.
Of course. I'm sure the science doesn't contemplate what you're talking about.
That's right. Not yet, or not at the level accepted before the public. What I share with you today is more towards non-human medical technology, non-human understanding.
I understand. That is to say that since growth is individual, there will be some people who will be able to change DNA faster than others. So, if DNA changes with age, these DNA banks will have to be updated. The altered DNA will no longer be the same as the stored DNA.
In theory, yes. However, the level of detail or precision is not sufficient at the human technological level to detect such subtle changes. It also so happens that the very bulk of the DNA, at the level needed to carry out their agendas, does not necessarily need such a level of precision or detail of the small intrinsic changes in an individual's DNA over time. With the one they have, they will be able to do their business quite well. However, it should be mentioned that these small changes add up to a larger one, and in turn to a larger one, reflecting a larger change in the person individual. In some cases, they do have to update their data. Parentheses. In the case of advanced non-human civilizations, holographic computers can develop predictive models that foresee the changes in stored DNA, thereby retaining their accuracy to a large extent. But this requires levels of computational technology far above the current human level, at least the official one.
And when we talk about the human genome, we are talking about the Lyrian genome, since it is only a part of the DNA or the DNA that differentiates us?
For me, genome is the set of DNA. For me.
So, Tigetans have one genome, Engans another, and humans another genome.
It would depend on the exact definition of the word genome. Basically, they are all Lyrians at base. Except that humans already present clear differences. For example, in terms of development of brain and nervous system structures, lack of telepathy and ESP, among other things, which have been altered on Earth with the use of perceptual and mental manipulation.
That's why the human is a secondary species, yes?
Unfortunately, this is considered to be the case. However, in the opinion of others, they are also considered to have the best genetics, so say the Andromedans, according to Collier.
And Yazi, Swaronians have the same DNA, right? Or is your DNA different from Mari's or Tina's?
We have it pretty much the same. Let's say that it is our genome that makes us or defines us as another race. But we each have our individual one. Although we accept that we are a spin-off or Tigetan variant.
Okay, thank you for clarifying this topic a little bit, because there were people who said that human DNA could not be collected.
Maybe in the media they are pushing that you can't, to get the public to look the other way while they do it. It's not even that hard. I don't understand why they say it can't be done. Or they don't see what for, ignoring all that is useful to them or all that can be done with that data in population control on the part of the cabal.